friend of mine once came up to me and asked me, you know what, brother, I have a marriage in my family and I want to buy gold 3 months down the line. The price right now is 50,000, but I'm worried in future the price will go up. What should I do? Is there any alternative solution for that? Then I was like, why don't you just go to a jewelry shop, fix the price right now and then buy that price 3 months down the line? He asked me, is it actually practically possible to do that? I was like, it happens every day. You just go to a jewelry shop, tell him after 3 months, I'll buy from you 50 grams of gold costing 50,000 rupees for 10 gram. Then my friend asked, why would the shopkeeper agree for that? Why should he be willing to give me at that price? I was like, the simple thing is this, if you are fixing a price right now, you have to pay certain amount of token money, could be 1% or 2% of the whole contract value. By that logic, you own the right to buy the gold at 50,000, but the shopkeeper becomes obligated to honor the right. So by just paying 2%, in a way you are buying the right on his asset, which is gold at that time. And then my friend asked, supposedly if the price of gold doesn't go up, it comes down only, then I'll be incurring losses. I was like, no, it doesn't happen that way. If you have paid him certain token money, which means you have bought the right, just in case the gold price comes down, you just tell him, I don't want to buy at whatever the agreed upon price was. You just keep the token money as your commission and the contract is null and void. But just in case the price goes up, say if the price of gold goes up to say 60,000 rupees, then in that case, you save 10,000 rupees for 10 grams, which for 50 grams amounts to 50,000 rupees. So that is what you can do. Now you must be wondering, why am I telling you this story? All I'm trying to do is, I'm trying to introduce you to the world of options. Now, if I were to connect the whole example here to the world of option, then in that case, the underlying asset, that is asset upon which I am agreeing the contract, is the gold. The amount of token money or the fees which he paid was the premium. The duration of the contract was 3 months, that becomes the time period, and that also becomes the expiry period. Now, those are the basic facets of options. Now, let me explain that to you with a financial example. Now, supposedly, if I have a bullish view on the shares of HDFC Bank, I'm thinking that in maybe 1 month down the line, the current price is 1500 rupees. Maybe I'm expecting within 1 month time, the price to go up to say 1600 rupees. Now I want to buy one lot of HDFC Bank. Now, how do I do that? I just can't buy one share, two share. I have to buy a specific amount of shares in that one lot. So in the world of options, you have to buy specific amount of lot. Now in one lot of HDFC Bank, there are about 550 shares. Imagine if you have to pay 1500 rupees to buy 550 shares, the amount becomes a huge number of 8,30,000 rupees. Now it is not practically possible for me to pay that much money because I don't have that much money. Now the other option which I think, that what if I could pay a certain token money or fees money, maybe 2%, 3%, 4%, and just get the right on the shares of HDFC Bank to be bought at current price and sold at an agreed upon price in future. Now that becomes a very interesting scenario in that case. So that is how the world of option works. Now before moving forward, if you are looking to open a DMAT account for trading and investment purpose, we will recommend you check out the platform of AliceBlue. It is a cutting-edge technology and they have made a very, very good product out of it. AliceBlue is one of the leading brokers in India that offers zero brokerage on equity delivery trades. That is, you don't have to pay any charges for your long-term investments. If you're holding your positions and carrying it over just to next day itself, you don't have to pay any charges for taking on that trade. Isn't that amazing? That is how good their platform is. For intraday futures and options, commodities and currency trading, they charge a flat rupees 15 per order, which is actually lesser than most of the other brokers in the country. And further, you can also trade using the power AliceBlue and technology. It is a cutting edge technology. It's beautifully designed and they have a very good interface. And why is it so special? Because it's very easy to monitor your trades, investments, and also they have a series of watch lists and it is very, very fast. So that is the benefit of using the and technology software. In short, you can save a lot of brokerage fees by trading with AliceBlue, as you can clearly notice that the brokerage charges are even lower than most of the major discount brokers in the country. And in addition to that, they've also waived off their account opening charges. Basically, they're not charging any money from you to open the account. So you can open your DMAT account for free and enjoy all the benefits which is being provided by this leading software in our country. Now the topic which I'm going to be talking about and which has become a topic of discussion, and it has been inquired by a lot of our users and viewers, saying that why don't you make a simple and an easy video to explain the concept of options trading for beginners. I'll try to make it as simple as possible. Let's see how much far we go in doing that. Now to define the options. Options are financial instruments debt are derivative instrument, that is, they derive their value from the value of the underlying asset. Now, it also gives the right to the option buyer to buy or sell the underlying asset at the agreed upon price at expiry within the specific amount of time. Now, there are various factors which I try to explain here. Financial instruments, if you take the example of HDFC Bank, HDFC Bank is the financial instrument and the options have derived the value from the HDFC Bank. Now, the underlying asset here is again the HDFC Bank. So, I've explained the three concepts. Financial instrument, derivatives are those products that derive the value, and the underlying asset is HDFC Bank. Now, if I want to express my view by buying the option contract, which means what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to say that I'm buying it right now and I'm expecting the price to increase in future. Now, that is how I express my bullish view on the HDFC Bank. And I have also set the time. I am saying that, okay, within specified amount of time, if you are already option trader, you must be knowing there's a 1 month expiry, 2 month expiry, 3 month expiry, and they expire on the last Thursday of every month. That is the last trading Thursday. And if the last trading Thursday is a holiday, it expires on the previous day. Now I'm saying within specified amount of time, I'm expecting the price of HDFC to go up. Just in case it goes up, I make the gain, but doesn't go up, it rather comes down. I just don't need to exercise my option. All I stand to lose is the premium which I paid to buy the option. So that is how simple concept of option trading works. Now basically there are two types of options. One is the call option, the other is the put option. And under the call option, there is a call option buyer, call option seller. Under the put option, there's a put option buyer, put option seller. Now, what does call option do? Call option is used when I'm having a bullish view on the share price of the underlying asset. And the put option is used when I'm having a bearish view. Now, you are saying that what is bullish view, what is bearish view? I'll tell you what. If supposedly in the example of HDFC Bank, I'm expecting the price to go up, which means I have a bullish view. And how do I express my bullish view? All I do is just go to the options market and buy a call option. And supposedly if I were to have a bearish view on HDFC Bank, all I do is buy a put option. So call option gives the right to the holder of the instrument to buy the underlying asset at a pre-decided price in future. And the put option gives the right or the holder of the instrument the right to sell the underlying asset at a pre-decided price in future. Those are two simple differences between call option and the put option. Now, let us get back to our HDFC Bank example. What I was saying that the current price is 1500 and I'm expecting the price of underlying asset to go up to 1600 in future, which means 1600 becomes my strike price. The strike price is that price which I'm anticipating the underlying asset to go within the specified time in the future. And I express my bullish view by buying a call option. Now, upon expiry, say if the price of HDFC Bank goes up, I'll be very happy because my views have gone right and I'm going to make money onto it. Now, the next thing which you would be having in your mind is that, is it okay if the price just goes to 1600 or it can also go more? I mean, obviously, if it goes more, the more benefit to you. You're expecting it to go to minimum 1600. Anything beyond that makes you a lot much more money than what you expected. And if it doesn't go up in future, then also it's fine. All you stand to do is lose the premium. Remember, I told you, if you are a buyer of an option, it gives you a right. It is not an obligation. It is an obligation for seller to honor the deed. Why so? Because he has charged you certain premium. If he has taken some token money, which means he is bound by the contract. But you are bound only if you want to exercise the option. And you're not bound if you don't want to exercise the option. That is how the simple mechanism of call option works. Now, supposedly, if what is put option, how do I explain it? If supposedly rather than having a bullish view, you would have had a bearish view on HDFC Bank. Say the current price is 1500 and you're saying that 1 month down the line, I expect the HDFC Bank price to come down to say 1400. But I can't be expressing my view by buying a futures contract because futures contracts are too expensive. You have to pay nearly 1.5 to 2 lakh rupees as margin with the broker. I don't have that much money. How do I express by with limited amount of capital? All you do is go to put options market, buy the strike price 1400, pay whatever the token money is, say 28 rupees, 30 rupees. Say if the price is 30 rupees, then the amount which you will pay is 30 into 550, which is the number of shares in one contract, which amounts to roughly rupees 16,000 to 17,000. Imagine for futures contract 1.2, 1.3, 1.4 lakh and only 15, 16,000 for buying a put option. 1/10 the price, but you get to ride the same amount of wave in the market. Supposedly now upon expiry, if the price of HDFC comes down to say 1350 rupees, so you stand to gain 1400, which is agreed upon price, minus 1350, that is 50 rupees per share, with 550 shares, which is 27,000 rupees. So just by paying 16,000 rupees, you made 27,000 rupees, which is a gain of 170-180%. But if you were to make similar money by using the futures contract, you would be making what? 727,000 rupees by paying 1.3 lakh rupees, which is a gain of 20%. So options give you the power of leveraging, and that is the power option. Now let us try and understand what are the profit potential points for both option buyer and option seller. Why should someone buy option? Why should someone sell option? Now for an option buyer, his risk is limited only to the tune of premium which he has paid. That is the only obligation which he has, just in case he doesn't want to exercise the right. Supposedly, if I paid say 10,000 rupees to buy a right on certain underlying asset, if the underlying asset view of mine doesn't go in my favor, I don't have to honor the contract. All I stand to lose is just the premium which I paid. But if I am a seller of an option and I have got that 10,000 rupees from you for surrendering my right to you, now by that logic I become obligated because I've taken certain token money. Just in case the underlying asset goes say 70-80,000 rupees in favor of buyer, then I'm obligated to pay that much money to him. So by that logic, the risk for option buyer is very limited and the reward potential is unlimited. For a call option seller, the potential is limited but his risk is unlimited. That's the payoff difference between a call option buyer and a call option seller. So that is it from us for the basics of option trading. There's a call option, there's a put option, right to buy, right to sell. The option buyer has a right, not an obligation, but the option seller is obligated to honor the contract just in case the contract goes in the favor of the option buyer. Now, one fun fact, in India, you don't need to own that many shares to be an option seller. Basically, I'm saying, okay, if I am selling 550 shares right to the option buyer, do I need to own that many shares? No. In India, you just need to pay the cash differential. You don't need to own that many shares physically with you, because that wouldn't be feasible. It wouldn't make sense to hold that many shares. So to participate in the options market, you don't need to own that many shares. You can just have enough margin money in your account. In case the position goes against you, you pay the cash differential and get done with the contract. So I hope this video was informative, gave you a basic insights about option, what is option trading, who does option trading, various facets of the option trading, call option buyer, call option seller, who buys, who sells. If you have any more doubts, questions, queries, put everything in the comment section. I'll be more than glad to answer. I thank you for your patient hearing. I'll again see you next video, Financial Education. Thank you so much.